Hi everyone, today we are introducing our most recent product, Explorer. Explorer will revolutionize the way you search for sounds in your library. It's a free standalone application to manage, search and export sounds directly into your projects and improve the workflow for sound designers. Stick around for the overview. In Explorer, you will find the main audio table, the right and the left inspector, as well as the mini editor. Let's start by setting up the app by opening Hardware and going to I/O Manager. Here you will find the audio interface settings. In the output buzz section, it's possible to route the output buzzes according to the interface available, even at different levels. In the ambisonics decoder, it's possible to select the output format of this decoder. And then in the bass management tab, the low frequency can be controlled by setting how the main channels and the LFE component are being sent to the subwoofers. In the binaural monitoring tab, there are already some responses that can be used, but you can also import your own. In the control room section, delays and gains can be applied to each channel to fine-tune your system, as well as sending noise to each speaker individually. It is possible to have more than one database at the same time in Explorer. A new database can be created in the top left corner, and you can name as many databases as you want. After creating an empty database, sounds can be imported from the import button or just simply drag and drop sounds directly to the Explorer workspace. Let's go back to our previous database and explore our search engine with keywords. Once you type the word in the keyword section, Explorer will automatically filter all the audios that include that word. You can also sort the table with the table headers. In this example, I'm sorting the table with the brightness parameter. Imagine that I want to find a sound that's around 400 Hz. This really helps me to get into the sounds with the centroid in the range that I'm looking for. In the advanced search menu, it is also possible to set more conditions. In this case, I'm looking for a file that's longer than 10 seconds. As you can see, now Explorer only shows files longer than 10 seconds. It is also possible to have more than one search at the same time. The ABC buttons will allow you to have multiple searches while storing the previous ones. An alternative to the table headers sorting is the randomize button. If you click this button, Explorer will always show you a different combination of the audios, so this way you can explore new audios. In the left inspector, there are four tabs. Starting with the category one, you can sort audios through categories and subcategories according to the UCS system. In the playlists tab, you can create your own playlists, both for specific sounds and for projects that you are working on. Simply add sounds to the categories that you've created as you go through your library, or just remove them by right-clicking and selecting the respective category. In the folder tab, you can see a tree structure where all the audios are according to the folder path. In the audio tab, you can also sort audios by file format, sample rate, and audio format. Also, the flagged audios can be found here. In the right inspector, all the properties from the selected sound can be found. The category can be changed. Also, you can change how Explorer is interpreting the selected file, as well as show all metadata and add your personalized notes. In the mini editor section, we have the transport bar with the reverse and play button, followed by the autoplay button. As you can see, when a new audio is selected, the play starts immediately. Also, there is the loop button that will loop within the selection made in the mini editor, and an FFT button to view the spectrogram of your audio file. It is also possible to have several time displays with all the units that you can see on the screen, and then add or remove time displays as you wish. Then we have the convert button that will convert your audio file both to multi-channel or ambisonics formats. And then there is also an option to only show some of the available channels. In the editing section, it is possible to apply fades, change the fade curves manually, or apply predefined curves. It is also possible to select the entire audio file or remove the selection. On the left-hand side, there is an effects rack where you can add effects such as invert, reverse, whoosh, normalize the audio, or even convert audios to a specific format. On the right side of the editor, there is a pitch wheel and a clip gain fader to change these effects in real time, as you can see in this example. At the bottom, there is an information button to show some information regarding the selected audio, and on the right side, there is an export and spot to button. Here, you can export audios or spot them directly into your digital audio workstation. Now, let's see some examples. I'm looking for an insect sound. In this case, I know exactly the sound that I'm looking for, and I know that the file is about 1 minute. So I'm going to use the advanced search here, as well as the categories to select the file that I'm looking for. And in the insect subcategory, I will select this Galapagos file and add it to my playlist of the jungle sound that I'm trying to recreate. Now I will look for a bird sound to add to this soundscape. Okay, this one seems fine, so I will just add it to the playlist. And then when I get here, I can just edit them, add some fades and spot them into my project. Because the file is already edited, I have a warning asking if I want to export the edited file or the original one. The sound of these insects seem to be more interesting with a higher pitch. And also, let's try a reverse effect here. Okay, I think this will do. So I will select the part that I want to export and then spot it to Pro Tools. As you can see, it's a very simple process. Now, let's hear the final result. In this example, I will find sounds for a sci-fi scene, and I'm looking for space sounds. Let's find some lasers. I want sounds with a centroid between 800 to 1.2 kHz, so I will sort them with the brightest parameter, and then flag the audio that I want to export to my project. I can also use the rating system for the sounds that I like the most. And then, if I go to the flagged audios, I can find them here and just select all of them and export them. I will select export as because I have the option to select the file format to export, the bit depth, and also the sample rate that I want to export my files. Now, just select where you want to save them in your computer, and you are done. This is it. Thank you all for watching. Please let us know your opinion in the comment section below. You can also download Explorer for free from our website or from the link in the description. Thank you and take care.